All right, welcome to Alejandro's All About Everything podcast. This is my first show. This is my intro. This is the intro into me and my show at the same time. It's simultaneous, just for your enjoyment. All right, so who am I? I'm Alejandro Cartagena, and I'm sexy, and I'm Puerto Rican, and I'm 27, and I'm a Cancer, and my dream is to become a radio broadcaster for all you people out there, but just so you can take my advice and know that I ain't some random guy on the street, I am certified by Boston University in audio production. I have my associates from Montgomery College in radio production, and I have my bachelor's from Towson University in radio production as well. So, with that said, don't doubt anything I say because I know my stuff. And moving on to the next topic. So on this show, we will be covering a lot of multitude of topics like hip-hop, music, any kind of genre of music, politics, relationships. What else is there? Current events, anything newsy or funny or headliney. You know, just throwing it out there. So it's never going to be the same thing on this show every single time. Nah, nah, nah. Or hot topics. Yes, thank you, Miss Maria, my assistant in the back. She is lovely, lovely, lovely. That's just a little quick intro into like what are the little topics we're going to do. Let me start off this with saying I'm going to do my little intro about hip-hop. And I found myself 5 hip-hop albums that you should go out and cop if you like hip-hop. And this is how I grade them. I grade them like this. I get them on iTunes, and I listen to the whole album front to back. And I grade them on whether or not the songs are worth being played on the radio and or if I enjoy them. And if they're both, I give them a 5 out of 5. And if I feel like it's something that's like my favorite, I give it a heart plus a 5 out of 5. So then I know it's really, really dope. And so with that said, that's how you know my rating goes. These are the 5 top albums to get right now in hip hop. And this is from 5 to 1. Number 5, Rick Ross, Rather You Than Me. Now, I like this album because it always has, Rick Ross always has great production. And I feel like even though he's not going to blow your brains out with lyrical mischief or stuff like that, but he's always going to have really, really good features. Like, I know he has Nas and Meek Mill. Who else does he have? Yo Gotti. And who else? Ty Dolla Sign, who I really like a lot too. But the tracks I would try to look for is Powers B, Trap, Trap, Trap. Was it Dead Presidents? And that's just a little quick review. That's my 5 out of, what was it, my number 5 on the list. And moving on. This is a new guy, and I listen to his album. He's definitely dope and something new. He's not talking about killing people, and he's definitely got a poetic kind of rap to it with a lot of the new kind of instrumentals that are going on in 2017. And his name is Shmino, and his album name is, I don't even know what it's called because it's just a bunch of letters, BLKSWN. I don't know what that stands for, but if I were you and you wanted to listen to something new and it wasn't repetitive stupidness over and over again, I would go out and get his album, which is Shmino. You know, number 3, Big Sean, I Decided. Now, I really like this album. He's number 3 on my list, so it's getting up there to the really, really, really good ones. And I feel like this album really established him as one of the premier rappers in hip-hop right now. And I'm not saying he's above any other rapper, but he's definitely put his name in. Because when he first came out, I definitely didn't think that was something that, I didn't think he was going to last that long anyway. So he's definitely changed my opinion of him. Because at first, I didn't like him. I thought his songs were stupid, and his voice sounded like a little 16-year-old girl going through puberty, and now it doesn't sound as bad or annoying to me. Moving on to number 2. Fat Joe and Remy Ma, Plata o Plomo, Money Over Bullets, or Money or Bullets. I love this album. I don't care if you don't like Fat Joe, or I don't know if you don't like Remy Ma, or whatever you got your biases on, and I don't care if he's Puerto Rican, I am Puerto Rican. The album is dope, it's crazy. I listened to the first song to the last song and didn't stop at all. And Remy Ma kills every verse. And it's half her album, so you know, just, you know, with that said, amazing. Get it. Number one. Now, this artist has changed my opinion about him a lot. When he first came out, I thought he was soft. I couldn't take him seriously because he was on Degrassi and a lot of other things that I had biases about. But over time, I feel that he's steadily taken over the game of hip-hop and become one of the best, better rappers out there. And I would have to go with my number one is Drake with More Life. And this album is very, very good. I listen to it front to back, and that's how I do every single album. Just so you know, if I'm not listening front to back, it's not worth your time. And the album, I gave it a 5 out of 5, and it's my number one because I feel that if you listen to an album and you can at least have half the songs are like bangers and they could be on the radio and be singles, then I feel like you're in the right ballpark of a 5 out of 5 microphone type album. And I feel like he definitely made his mark with this album, especially after the last album, which these last two albums are very, very good. I would definitely get the last one, which I don't remember, which was good too. It wasn't even that long ago he put it out. So he's putting out a lot of consistently good music, a lot. So, with the wrap up, here's my top five again. Rick Ross, Rather You Than Me. Shmino, BLKSWN. I don't know what that stands for. Don't ask me. Big Sean, I Decided. Fat Joe and Remy Ma, Plata o Plomo. And Drake, More Life. And that's my little tidbit on hip hop today. With that, I'm gonna go ahead and switch it up on y'all because the other day I was at Golden Corral. That's not really a super fancy place or anything like that. And I was with my parents and I was with my girlfriend Maria, beautiful Byrus. And it was a great evening. Everybody was having fun, a lot of laughs, all that good stuff. And then I started choking on a taco. That was not fun. Not fun at all. And, you know, so I tried to get, like, my father was getting his food. So if, I don't know if you know about Golden Corral, but it's pretty much just go stand up, go get your food, come back. And the only people that I had to take were my girl and my mother. And I started choking. And I don't know if you know me, but I don't know if you know, but this is the international sign for choking. Help me now. I started doing that, and my girl started getting my attention to my mother, started screaming, and then my mother was screaming high loud, very loud, like, Tony, 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 Tony! And this has to be a pretty big Golden Corral. It wasn't a small place, at least 100 people plus in the whole restaurant. And you know what, people? No one did a damn thing. They just all watched me as I choked. Almost to death. And how would you ask me how I know? Because just because I'm choking for my life doesn't mean I can't see everything that's going on in my life. / my girlfriend over there told me there was a bunch of white people and stuff like that just eating their food. Like if I was a show. Like, oh, look at that guy's choking. That's pretty cool, right? Man, this roast beef is really tasty. F that guy. And F all those other people at the damn Golden Corral. Yeah, so that taught me a lesson. And the only reason I'm here right now is because while I was choking, this guy had to be Puerto Rican. Ask me why? Because this guy was yelling in my ear, I got you, Papa. I got you, Papa. Don't worry, Papi. I got you. I got you. I got you. And if you know, it's only how Puerto Ricans talk or Dominicans. So that guy saved my life. And everyone in the Golden Corral started clapping. Everyone that didn't help me, that is. So, life lesson, if you want to survive, don't start choking on your food in Golden Corral, or any public places, that is. And I did a little research, because I was kind of astonished, but there's this thing called the bystander effect, which means everyone's always going to worry about the next person standing up and taking action. So, if you have 100 people, within those 100 people, everyone's thinking someone else is going to step up, and no one's going to step up, unless you have someone lucky enough to come out and save your hide. You know, because what if that was you? What if you were in a public place and you were choking to death and everybody was just staring at you and they just watched you slowly drift into death? Would that be acceptable? Would that be something that you would want? Knowing that, you know, maybe if you're on the other side too, you're watching someone choke to death. Could you really know that you can go to sleep tonight, that night, knowing that that person died and you didn't do anything? You didn't even try to help them. Maybe you don't know how to do the Heimlich maneuver. Maybe you don't know how to do anything. What you could do is call the police, call the ambulance, yell for help, get someone's attention, find someone that actually does know what to do. Just something. But standing by and just watching is not acceptable. It's not right. And as a society, we're failing. And you got to think about it like this. I've heard plenty of stories where people have been beat up in public places, raped, stabbed, shot. Why? Because the bystander effect. Because people weren't willing to step up to the plate and save someone else's life because they were only worried about themselves. Or they were saying to themselves, well, you know, that sucks for that person. But what if that was you? What if you were by yourself in a crowd and everybody was watching you and you got beat up with a hammer and no one stepped up to you? 100 people cannot overtake one person, even with a hammer or a knife or something. Maybe not a gun, but at least 100 people, 50 people, 5 people should be able to overcome one man or a woman, whatever is happening. I don't think it's okay to sit back and just accept this, especially when I went through it myself. I even went on Facebook. This is how it correlates with too. I went on Facebook, I asked the same question. You know how many answers I got from that? 2. My girlfriend and another person. That's how much people don't care about answering questions about, you know, helping other people. That's booty. Booty. So, what can we do? You could start acting a little bit more or less about yourself. You could do more community service. I don't know. I don't want to tell you what to do with your life. But, you know, you could do something. You can't just sit there and accept whatever life is happening. Because we are, as a people, we create society. We can't just allow society to continue the way that we are when no one wants to stop it or say, hey, maybe we're not doing the right thing here. But enough of all that. I want to leave my audience off with this today. Sometimes you might think it might not help to help another person, and it might not be a big thing. It might be very small. Maybe just saying hi to someone. Maybe just saying, treating a homeless person with respect and as a human being. Maybe giving, you know, maybe you're in the line at a grocery store and someone doesn't have enough change. Maybe they're off by like a couple bucks. You know, maybe you should just reach into your pocket and just give them the, you know, a couple bucks so you can be like, you know what? You might have a hard day. We might have a hard day. Everyone might be going through a hard day. But you know what? This is not going to be one of those things that's going to happen to like break you. You know, because one thing that I know is, when you do one thing that's good, another thing comes out of that. And then maybe it's a spiral effect. And then you find yourself in a world where things that we didn't believe are true and do exist, like helping others and being courteous and respectful and not rude and caring about other people's feelings, but not to the point where it's like, I don't know, ridiculous. But with that said, I hope that you guys or whoever's watching this can take this and say to yourselves, you know, like, what can I do to become a better person? And what can I do to become a better person in our society? And hopefully that'll make you a little bit happier inside. And it might not work on the first day, but trust me, like, you do something good for someone else and it's not for yourself and it's not to, you know, get money or to get respect or to put yourself out there. It feels good. And it makes you appreciate the simple things, like having a simple conversation with a stranger on the train that they're by themselves. Maybe it's an old woman. Maybe she's by herself. She has no one's around her. She doesn't look happy. But you know what? Just spark conversation. You're not leading to anything at all, but you know what? Maybe it makes that person's day. You never know. You never know. So with that, I end my first podcast and the beginning of something amazing, which is Alejandro's All About Everything podcast. Peace.